Hey, what's up guys? Welcome to the another episode of iGeeks blog and I am your host, Dhvanis. One of the most common issues I have faced on every iPhone that I have used over the years is touchscreen unresponsiveness. Have you ever experienced the same issue and looking for a fix? In this video, I have jotted down some of the effective solutions that actually work in fixing the frozen screen of the iPhone. So let's get into the video. Before we start, make sure to subscribe our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to never miss any update from the iGeeks blog. The screen protector might have gone off the boil. If it was too old and littered with fingerprints and scratches, you may need to change it. Remove the screen protector, clean the screen with a soft cloth and check out if the touchscreen is properly functioning or not. I would recommend to use cleaning wipes. Find the link of the recommended wipes in the description below. If the screen protector is not an issue, then let's take a look at the possible software fixes. At times, touchscreen becomes unresponsive while using certain apps. If it is the case, delete the app and reinstall it again. It may fix the frozen screen issue. Sometimes a hard reboot can do a job for you. The reason why I suggest to hard reboot is that it's able to flush out bad bits that tend to get stuck at times. If you have the iPhone 10 or iPhone 8, then quickly press and release volume up key, then quickly press and release volume down key, and then press and hold side button until Apple logo appears. Do you have an iPhone 7? Then press and hold volume down key and power button until the Apple logo appears. If you are having iPhone 6 or earlier models, then press and hold home button and power button until Apple logo appears. Once your iPhone has restarted, there is a high possibility that your iPhone responds to your touch. Now it's time to take even longer route. If rebooting an iPhone did not solve the problem, I would suggest to restore your iPhone as a last workaround. Before you start, make sure to take a backup of your device using iTunes. I would suggest to restore your iPhone in DFU mode or recovery mode because they are known to fix more complex issues than a traditional restore. I have mentioned article link in the description below which will walk you through the process. After your device has restored, the touchscreen will begin to work as desired. If you have found success, congratulations. If there is still no luck, then there is a possibility of damaged hardware and it's time to contact Apple support. I hope you like this video, then give us thumbs up, share this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. I am signing off. Thanks for watching and we'll catch you in another episode.